today. Hello, this is Mary Reeves, and you're listening to The Ralph Emery Show.
Hi, Mary. Welcome back to our show.
Thank you.
During Country Music Month, we are saluting the performances and the life of Jim Reeves. Mary is our guest, and you're going to hear some great songs on this show. We're happy to have you back with us, Mary.
Thank you.
Gold Medal Flower brings you the show, and Tammy Wynette has the first song.
My man, understand. He holds me in the palm of his hand, and I like it. I like it. He's the dream, the real thing. He always makes me feel like a queen, and I love it. I love it. His arms are warm. They keep me away from harm, and I'm proud of it. So proud of it. Mine. He's fine, he makes a funny feeling go up my spine, and I want to keep it like this all the time. He's got what I want, what I wanted. He's got what I need, what I needed. I'd fight a million just to keep it, just to keep on holding. To work later, can't stand it, can't stand it. But when he walks in and I'm in his loving arms again, I forget it, I forget it. Yes, touch is too much. He knows how to love me just enough, and I love him, I love him. I'm understand, he holds me in the palm of his hand, and I want to keep it like this all the time. He's got what I want, what I want it. He's got what I need, what I need.
Opening our show, Tammy Wynette, Tammy singing My Man. The Gold Medal folks would like to share something with you.
Make someone a gold medal memory today.
Mama would call from the kitchen door, come on, it's time to bake some more. I'd be there on the run, 'cause I knew we'd have lots of fun.
Baking up a gingerbread man, baking up a gingerbread man. Get the gold medal flour and the baking pan, baking a gingerbread man.
Now my daughter's 6 years old, and she doesn't have to be told. When it's gold medal baking day, I can always hear her say,
we're baking up a gingerbread man, baking up a gingerbread man. Get the gold medal flour and the baking pan, baking a gingerbread man, baking a gingerbread man. Make someone a gold medal memory today.
Our guest is Mary Reeves, and Mary, we're delighted to have you back with us to talk about Jim. And I thought we'd play Am I Losing You as the first of his records on this show, if that's all right with you.
Mm-hmm. That'd be a good one.
Do you have any significant memory of this song?
Well, that Jim wrote it, I think, would be one of the most significant ones, and I do remember when he wrote it.
This was an early hit for him, about 1957,
I guess. Yeah, it sure was. Uh-huh. And he recorded it, as you'll hear him say, several times.
Why did he cut this song so many times?
Well, he wanted to get it perfect, and it just never did come off the way he wanted it to come off. And I don't really know why.
Was it released four times, or was it just recorded four times?
Just recorded four times.
How many times was it released while he was living?
Two times.
And I presume, determined that the second release was better than the first.
Yeah.
Well, that's the one we will play.
Okay.
Here's now this is Jim's comment on this song.
Well, I'm glad to see this tune on the list because it's one that I wrote. So if you don't like it, you can blame me entirely for this one. It's been recorded four times and was a pretty good hit. It was actually one of my very early recordings. Am I Losing You?
Am I losing you? Are my fears coming true? How I wish I knew. Am I losing you? Is your love really true? Is there somebody new? Tell me what to do. Am I losing you? Am I too blind to see? What's been happening to me? Every road has a bend. Will I be sweetheart or friend? Will the sweet things you do be for somebody new? What to do? Am I losing you? Am I too blind to see?
Too blind to see
what's been happening to me?
Happening to me.
Every road has a bend.
Road has a bend.
Will I be sweetheart or friend?
Sweetheart or friend.
Will the sweet things you do be for somebody new? Tell me what to do. Am I losing you?
Losing.
Mary, didn't this song we've just played mark the beginning of a new style of singing for Jim, soft and smooth, as opposed to singing in a higher range that he did previously, like on Mexican Joe and Bimbo and those songs?
Yeah, it sure did. Uh-huh. That was sort of the year or the era when this type of singing really came back in.
Why did Jim Reeves change his style?
Well, in the beginning, you see, the low style was his regular style, but in the 1952 and 53, the Webb Pierces and so on were hitting, and they were singing high. So he thought that's what he should do.
To hit, sing high.
That's right.
Well, you've heard the voice of Jim Reeves sing, Am I Losing You? Hey, here's a fella I call the mainest cheating heart of all. He's been fronting the Hank Williams Band for years and the Hank Williams Jr. Band, and I think he's got a great voice. And another friend of mine, Red Steigall, wrote this song. Let's listen to Lamar Morris.
Here we go again. She's back in town again. I'll take her back again. One more time. Here we go again. The phone will ring again. I'll be her fool again. One more time. I've
been there before, and I'll try it again. But any fool knows there's no way to win.
Here we go again.
She'll break my heart again. I'll play the part again. One more time. Back in town again, I'll take her back again, one more time.
Here we go again,
the phone will ring again, I'll be her fool again, one more.
That's Lamar Morris on the show, his great voice turning out Here We Go Again. Mary, I'd like to introduce you to the first donuts that are easy to make.
Donuts are not easy, Ralph.
Well, new no-fry donuts from Gold Medal Flour are. They're different from any other kind because you don't fry them or even need them. Just bake them in the oven and you've got them made. Tender, luscious, and I can smell them already. You've got your choice of three flavors, cinnamon sugared, applesauce, or chocolate. When you make them, be sure and use Red Star yeast. It has absolutely no preservatives, so it's natural in every way. Red Star is dependable and easy to use, too. Now that it's autumn, bake up some easy no-fry donuts to go with that fresh-pressed apple cider. Where do you get the recipe? Why, in gold medal sacks that say, no fry donuts. Mary, had Jim Reeves lived, I'm sure he would have been even bigger than he was. And I'm sure he would have been a major factor on television. What's your opinion about that?
Well, I agree with that. Because I think he was the type of person who would have gone after what would be the big thing to do in now whatever era it was.
He had his own network radio show, didn't he?
Yes, he did, in 1958.
On ABC Radio.
Mm-hmm.
It was a daily show, wasn't it?
Yes, it was the noon hour.
And it was a variety show.
Mm-hmm.
Now, as I understand it, Jim did have some tentative plans for a television show.
Yes, he did.
The fact is, he's going to comment on that right here.
I have plans for a television series. It may not materialize, but we've made a pilot, and it looks pretty good. Looks like it might come off.
Mary, what happened to that television pilot? Were there plans made for that to become a nationwide show?
Yes, he was working on that idea, but of course, nothing ever happened about it. I think it was premature or something. I don't really know what happened.
But probably had he lived, it would have happened.
Oh, yeah. I think so. Mm-hmm.
All right. Let's get to another song here. You might introduce this fella. He records for the Little Dog label.
Yeah, well, he sure does.
The Little Dog label.
And he is a gentleman and just a prince of a guy. And we're talking about Charlie Pride. And he's going to sing for us She's Too Good to Be True.
Hmm. He is.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes late at night, I wake up dreaming. I reach and feel for her, she's too good to be true. Then I touch the sleeping softness of my angel, and half asleep she turns to whisper, I love you.
cause she's just too good to be true. But she is, and in my arms she reassures me with a kiss. She's everything I ever looked for in a woman. She's just too good to be true, but she is. Each day I go to work, it's like forever. Till that evening sun will bring me home again. But then she's a-waiting at the door with her sweet loving. And tonight she'll be so good to me again. Oh, she's just too good to be true, but she is. And in my arms she reassures me with a kiss. She's everything I ever looked for in a woman. She's just too good to be true, but she is. She's just too good to be true, but she is.
Charlie Pride, sometimes referred to as Super Charlie. Charlie with She's Too Good to Be True. Mary, I'll turn to you again and let you play disc jockey on this program. Oh. So you might tell us who's next.
It's Dolly Parton. And
I've heard the name.
Yes, indeed. With Wash Day Blues.
Mercy. You ever been in the... Have you heard this record?
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever been in this position?
Yes, sir.
Wash them old work britches?
Yeah, on that old scrubbing board.
Mercy. Here's Dolly.
Last Saturday night I looked like a princess dressed in calico. Down blue Monday wash day I looked like a lady hobo, just rubbing and scrubbing. And I ran to the mall, I gotta hang them out early, I hope the sun comes
wash
out.
Wash them out, bring them out, hang them on the line. Get a little tired, just think about the heat time.
Wash day blue. Soap they advertise, rubbing and scrubbing. And I ran to the mall, gotta hang them out early, hope the sun comes
wash
out.
Wash them out, bring them out, hang them on the line. Get a little tired, just think about the good time.
Wash day blue. Well, that good looking, good loving, no good man of mine could buy me a washing machine. But he spends all his money on payday to make me look like a queen. Now I'm rubbing and scrubbing and rinsing them out. Gotta hang them out early and hope the sun comes
wash
out.
Wash them out, bring them out, hang them on the line. Get a little tired, just think about the good time.
Wash day blues. Boy, I hate to wash an arm worse than anything in the world. If we ever get rich, first thing I'm gonna do is make my old man get me a maid, and then I'll have it made, cause he has really sent me through the ringer. Boy, I hate dirty diapers. I've worn so many diapers, I got diaper rash on my hands. These old stiff working bridges have got my hands all...
Sweet singing Dolly Parton. Dolly on our show singing the Wash Day Blues. And now, my friends, it's time for Paul Ott.
I remember when I was little playing cowboys with my brother Billy. Once we rode our make-believe horses right through the kitchen, and we scared mother so bad she dropped the flour she was sifting. She chased us and Said if the cookies didn't come out just right, it was all our fault. But I could see she was laughing while trying to look so stern. And when the cookies were done, she gave us some hot right out of the oven with cold milk from the spring house. Mother said gold medal flour and a Betty Crocker recipe gave her a margin for error when she baked. You know, in my mind, I can still see Mother and Billy and me eating those cookies as we sat at the old pine table in the kitchen back home. Bake someone a gold medal memory today.
Mary, in the second half of this show, I'd like to talk a bit about the Jim Reeves Memorial at Carthage, Texas. I believe that's the location,
mm-hmm.
isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
And there is a memorial to him, and
yes.
he's buried there, isn't he?
Yes,
right out of Carthage, isn't it?
Yes, it's about 3 miles east.
On a major highway?
Yes, on Highway 79.
All right, we'll talk more about that. Right now, we're going to combine the talents of Miss Sue Thompson from Las Vegas, the redheaded gal with the baby voice, and that handsome young fellow from Shelby, North Carolina, Don Gibson, and they're going to sing together.
That's what a body does when he falls in love. I don't know how to put in words just how it feels to kiss you when we have to be apart. It sure is strange the way I miss you. And sometimes I find myself a-smiling for no reason at all. Strangest kind of feeling I ever saw. And I think they call it love. Our friends have all been saying that's what a body does when he falls in love.
Sometimes I'll catch you looking at me, and I hear you breathe a sigh, and I get the warmest feeling from the look that's in your eyes. And sometimes I find myself forgetting some things I should do. Mostly I find I'm thinking of just you.
And I think they call it love. Our friends have all been saying that's what a body does when it falls in love. That's what a body does when he falls in love.
Hey, Mary, remember when Sue Thompson used to sing Norman and songs
mm-hmm.
like that?
Yeah.
She'll have that baby voice when she's 85.
At least.
Don Gibson and Sue Thompson on our show singing I Think They Call It Love. My friends, this is Ralph Emery, and our guest is Mary Reeves, and we're playing records by a lot of folks, and especially by Jim Reeves, and we're going to have another fascinating story about another Jim Reeves hit in just a few minutes, so stay with us. Right now, we're going to listen to a whole gang of folks, Mother Maybelle and her brood, and Big John Cash, and The World Needs a Melody.
The world needs a tune that it can hum. The world needs a guitar that it can strum. The
world needs a melody that it can sing, 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 sing. Let's all sing together. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. The world needs a bell that it can chime. The world needs a drum to keep the time. The world needs a melody that it can sing, 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 sing. Let's all sing together. Gonna lay down my burdens down by the riverside. The world needs a leader for its land. The world needs a melody that it can sing, 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 sing. Let's all sing together.
That's the Carter family, Mother Maybelle and June and Helen and the one they call Nito, Anita, with Johnny Cash singing The World Needs a Melody. Now we're going to play a record in a moment by Jim Reeves called I Love You Because, and there are a lot of significant things about this song. This was not a big hit in America, but it was in England, wasn't it, Mary?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they took it from an LP over there, and it was just a fantastically big record, over a million copies.
Didn't this knock the Beatles out of their number one slot in the British charts?
Yeah, it sure did, along with Frank Sinatra and a few other people who were big at that time.
Do you have any way to account for the fact that Jim was so popular in England?
Well, not really, except that I think that the British people are just sort of like we are here, you know, and they liked good country music. That's it.
Well, no, they didn't refer to Jim, though, as a country singer, did they?
No, they didn't. He was referred to as a pop singer.
I presume they liked his smooth style.
Yeah, I guess so. Mm-hmm.
Now, Jim is going to, we're going to play another track here by Jim where he talks about this song. He also talks about one of the great songwriters, Leon Payne, who wrote a lot of great songs, including this song.
Mm-hmm.
So let's get Jim Reeves' comments first of all.
One of the old country and western songs was written by a friend of mine in San Antonio, Texas. His name is Leon Payne. Leon is totally blind. His wife is totally blind, yet they have reared a family, and his wife, who he very affectionately refers to as Mutt, keeps the household, does all the cooking, and she's totally blind. But if you went to their house to visit, you would be served in a manner second to none. She knows where everything is, you know, goes about her cooking and housekeeping. Well, he wrote this song that I recorded for an album about 2 years ago, as well as a lot of other artists who've recorded it through the years. Leon did it originally himself, in the late 40s. It was a hit then. It's been a hit almost every year since, and now it's my turn, thank goodness.
I might add here that Leon Payne, of course, one of country music's great songwriters, passed away about 2 years ago. This comment on the life of Leon Payne was made about 4 months prior to Jim's death, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. That was in April 64.
April of 1964. Mm-hmm. Let's listen to Jim Reeves sing this great country classic.
I love you because you understand, dear. Every single thing I try to do, you're always there to lend a helping hand, dear. I love you most of all because you're you. No matter what the world may say about me, I know your love will always see me through. I love you for the way you never doubt me, but most of all I love you 'cause you're you. I love you because my heart is lighter every time I'm walking by your side. I love you because the future's brighter, the door to happiness you open wide. No matter what the world may say about me, I know your love will always see me through. I love you for 100,000 reasons, but most of all I love you 'cause you're you.
That was the voice of the immortal Jim Reeves. By the way, Mary, you showed me one time a platinum record from, I think, Norway, and wasn't it for I Love You Because, this song we've just played?
Yeah, and also a diamond record and two or three more.
Where was the diamond record from?
From Norway, because at that time they weren't set up for that many sales of any one record.
Didn't Jim, am I correct in saying he had the biggest record in the history of Norway?
Yes.
Or Norwegian music?
That's right. His records, or that one record, sold more than the whole industry in Norway.
So what were the worldwide sales of that song?
Well, it was really fabulous, and I don't know exactly because I don't get the tabulations from overseas broken down like that. For royalty statements.
Well, what would you estimate?
I would say about 2 or 3 million.
And in foreign countries with fewer people, they don't normally sell as many records as they do in the United States.
No, no, they don't.
Mm-hmm. Well, the song was certainly a fabulous success for Jim Reeves and made him an international star.
Yeah.
One of the songs that did, anyway. Mm-hmm. The voice of Jim Reeves on our show singing I Love You Because. Remember how much time and effort your mother spent baking? Used to take hours. But today, Gold Medal Flour makes baking easy enough for a beginner. How? Well, in the Betty Crocker kitchens, talented home economists are constantly developing new recipes and updating old favorites to make baking easier, quicker than ever before. Blender cakes, one-rise mixer breads, pat-in-the-pan pie crust. Revolutionary recipes like these are given to you free in gold medal sacks. And even though they're as modern as tomorrow, they taste just as good as the old-fashioned baking you remember. What's more, when you bake a Betty Crocker recipe with gold medal flour, it comes out right, even if you make little measuring mistakes. That's why they say gold medal gives you a margin for error. So why don't you bake a gold medal memory today's way with a Betty Crocker recipe? How about a record by a pretty girl? Here's Susan Ray.
The Wheel of Fortune goes spinning around. Will the arrow point my way? Will this be my day?
Miss Susan Ray reviving the oldie, the old K-Star hit, Susie doing the Wheel of Fortune. Mary, I mentioned earlier that we were going to talk about the Jim Reeves Memorial that people can go and visit, so why don't you tell us about it?
Well, it's a life-size granite statue, I suppose what you call it, of Jim, and it stands on a pedestal, a six-foot pedestal, and it's in a two-acre plot of ground that we try to keep beautiful, and that's all there is in it except flowers and trees. And we're delighted if somebody feels that they could go by there and see it.
Now, you might give us the location again.
It's 3 miles east of Carthage, Texas, on Highway 79 towards Shreveport.
So how far from Shreveport, Louisiana would it be?
It would be about 35 miles.
Isn't Cheyenne buried there?
Oh, yeah.
You might tell them about Cheyenne.
Well, Cheyenne was a collie dog that was a favorite of Jim's and mine, too, of course. And he died in, about a year after Jim did. So I just buried him there, too.
Was he old or...
Well, he was 10 years old. He had a heart attack, so I don't really know. I think he just got too fat.
I see. And he's buried there, too,
yeah,
at that plot. Well, I hope that some of our listeners, or many of them, will be able to get by and see this edifice, this tribute to Jim Reeves.
Yeah, I do, too.
Now, we're talking about Texans. It's awful hard to pass up Johnny Bush when you get to talking about Texans. Johnny Bush and Ray Price and Ernest Tubb and all those people. Johnny's going to sing Whiskey River.
I'm drowning in a whiskey river, bathing my memoried mind in the wetness of its soul, feeling the amber current flow around my mind, and warm my empty heart she left so cold. Run dry. You're all I've got. Take care of me. Bathing my memoried mind in the wetness of its soul, feeling the amber current flow from my mind, and warm my empty heart she left so cold. Whiskey River, take my mind. All I've got, take care of me.
Johnny Bush on our show, and that's also from Country Music's Top 10, Johnny Bush singing Whiskey River. Do you wish you could make fresh donuts without having to bother with the greasy mess associated with frying? Then just listen to this word from Gold Medal Flour.
Just bake them in the oven and you got them made. They're called no-fried donuts and they turn out great. Cinnamon, sugared applesauce or chocolate made the new Gold Medal way. When the season changes and the leaves start turning brown, that's when your family wants donuts, but you just don't have the time. But now your troubles are over, Gold Medal's found a new way to make your family donuts, the brand new no-fry way. Just bake them in the oven and you got them made. They're called no-fry donuts and they turn out great. Cinnamon, sugared applesauce or chocolate made the new Gold Medal way. Made the new Gold Medal way.
Now, doesn't that sound like a great treat? Why not bake a batch for your family today? The recipe is in sacks of Gold Medal Flour. Mary, in closing this show, another classic from, I suppose, the late 50s, the song Four Walls, which I think came along after Am I Losing You, didn't it?
Yes, it was in 1957, in the spring, I believe it was. And it was just Jim's very first big pop record too, as well as country.
It was kind of novel at that time for a country record to go pop too, wasn't it?
Yeah, oh, definitely. It just was unheard of.
Our people didn't cross over the line much, did they?
No.
All right, let's listen again to Jim Reeves as he sings Four Walls.
Out where the bright lights are glowing, drawn like a moth to a flame. You laugh while the wine's overflowing, while I sit and whisper your name. Four walls. Sometimes I ask why I'm waiting, but my walls have nothing to say. I'm made for love, not for hating. So here, where you left me, I'll stay. One night with you is like heaven. And so, while I'm walking the floor, I listen for steps in the hallway and wait for your knock on my door. Four walls to hear me, four walls to see, four walls to hear me closing in on me, closing in on me.
For Country Music Month, another Jim Reeves classic, that song, Four Walls. Gold Medal Flower has brought you our show, a tribute to Jim Reeves. And Mary, it's nice to have you back with us.
Thank you. Look
forward to joining you tomorrow.
Be right here.
With more stories and songs.
Right.
And Ralph Emery is thanking you for listening. I hope you'll try that Gold Medal Flower sometime, too.